Hello everyone. So in our last video, we were discussing about the CM2 guidance for answering the September 2020 paper. Here, what we were doing was we were solving the September 2019 term paper, and we have already seen how to solve the first 5 questions. We are left with the rest 5 questions over here. Now, I want to just continue with one thing which I want to show you all, which is in the last video I was talking about how we can create the payoff using the table. Over here, what I did not speak about was you will always have to mention the time if the time is given in the question. So if this is time 0, if this is time 1, this is time 2, you need to mention it. And how you can mention it? Obviously, you can mention it within the table itself. So if you want to insert any row, what do you do? Take your cursor in the middle of two rows and see, you will be able to insert a new row. And then what you can do is, instead of writing 96.8 in this, I'll just cut, control X, cut, control V, paste it over here, and then you can specify your duration, time duration, whatever is there in the question in the very first row. So all these, and if it's payment, if it's the payoff, whatever it is, you can just mention it on the very first row. It becomes really important. You need to label whatever you are doing, right? You just can't make something the examiner will not understand as to what you have done. You have to write payoff matrix or payoff tree, and then you have to give the labeling and accordingly, right? So moving on, we'll do the sixth question now. The sixth question over here, the examiner's report of September 2019. So we do not see much of algebraic notations over here. We have k e to the power minus r t minus t. I'll show you all how to write this equation. It's very simple. So let me just divide the screen into two, and let me just zoom this into a bit, right? So it's not very difficult to follow through. We have done these kinds in the previous video. So here I will start with question number 6 we are doing, and we are in the first part, right? So here we have this equation which I'm going to write p t. You can just simply write t if you want to, or what you can do is, again, we'll use a shortcut, control plus sign, control plus, and see, this gets activated, the subscript button gets activated, pt, and then just make sure this is not a capital P, whatever you want it to be, because it's in the start of the, so we do not want this to happen, and it should be a small p, right? Plus, you need to, obviously, whenever you click on control plus, again click on the control plus to move out of the subscript, otherwise whatever you type next will be shown in the subscript section only. PT, we have ST, again I can use the subscript, control plus T, control plus. So it's very simple if you use the shortcut which is control plus, instead of using the shortcut, instead of clicking on this button, going on to the home tab and clicking on this icon, it's better that you use the shortcut key. Here we have, this should be greater than equal to, so you can write greater than equal to in this manner, K multiplied by E to the power, so to the power, or if you do not want to write it to the power, you can, what you can do is, again, you can use the superscript. Now using the superscript, the shortcut key is control shift and plus, so control shift plus, and see, it activates the superscript button over here. So we'll write minus r in bracket, we'll give t minus t. This is all, again we'll click on control shift plus, and we move out of the superscript portion. This also you can do, or you could have just simply written this way, e to the power, and then whatever you want to give in the power, you can write it within your brackets, right? So this is how I can simply write this thing down, or you can use this as well. Both are correct, both are equivalently correct, right? So moving on, the next portion which we see, this is also exactly in the similar fashion. So this is, again, you can just simply write less than equal to in the similar fashion. No worries, all are good. Moving on to the seventh question, so what they have given us, the IFOA has given us, in the sixth question, they have also stated that you can use the subscript or the superscript if you want to. You can use a superscript just like this. Otherwise, you can use the symbol, the caret symbol. We generally call this as the caret symbol. X to the power 2. Both are correct. Moving on to the seventh question. Now, the seventh question contains a little bit of algebraic expressions over here. As you can see, we have beta I, we have covariance. So, all of this again is taken care of by the IFOA. Beta can again be written in the form of beta, B-E-T-A, and then I can be given in the subscript using the subscript in the word, or you can use the beta from the insert symbol section, from the Greeks section, you can insert beta and then you can just simply use a subscript to write I. So both are equivalently correct, both can be done. Similarly, we have pi over here. Both the things are acceptable. You can write pi, pi, and then write I, or you can again go to the insert symbol section and you can insert the symbol pi from there. Now, what IFOA has talked about is that this question has some amount of algebra. So, this would require some kind of adaptation to make it suitable for answering it in words. So, two things can be done. Again, the very first thing is that they can convert it into the multiple choice question. या फिर उन लोग क्या कर सकते हैं, इसी क्वेश्चन को ऐसे फ्रेम करके दे सकते हैं कि आपको एल्जेब्रा कम से कम यूज़ करना पड़े. यू जस्ट हैव टू मे बी मेंशन द पैरामीटर्स, द न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज और द फाइनल आंसर. द मेन एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन विच यू सी मे बी गिवन बाय द IFOA इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर इटसेल्फ, सो दैट यू डू नॉट हैव टू टाइप इट डाउन इन टू द वर्ड. इट विल बी क्लियरली मैंशनड कि आप खाली न्यूमेरिकल्स दिखा के सॉल्व करो, खाली न्यूमेरिकल्स निकालो या फिर आप कोई पैरामीटर्स या फिर जो भी कन्वीनियंट लगे IFOA को, ताकि आपका जो टाइपिंग है ऑफ द नोटेशंस वो रिड्यूस हो सके. ठीक है. एंड ऑल्सो व्हाट दे हैव कंसिडर्ड हियर इज दैट मार्क एलोकेशन मे बी एडजस्टेड. व्हाट डू आई मीन बाय दिस इज दैट अगर क्वेश्चन सेवन का इफ आई सी ओवर हियर द टोटल मार्क्स फॉर क्वेश्चन सेवन over here is, as you can see, 13. So question 7 ka total marks is 13. So what the IFOA will do if this question is to appear in your September 2020 term, what they can do is that they can increase this marks from 13 to maybe 14 or 15. So they will give you extra 1 or 2 marks considering the time taken to type it down into the word, considering the amount of algebra it has. So depending, it may increase 2 or 3 marks. 1 to 3 marks, the range can be 1 to 3, to increase the marks so that it will give more weightage to this question, just because of the time factor which is there, because time आपका थोड़ा ज़्यादा consume हो जाएगा when you type it into the word, and also the amount of algebra it contains, right? So this is what IFOA has clearly mentioned over here. What IFOA has clearly mentioned in their document is that the marks can be adjusted. And ये कैसे adjust होगा? ये adjust होगा as per a candidate who is well prepared in how to type this into the word. Like अगर ये एक candidate who a student who is well prepared for the examination will take maybe 13 to 15 minutes to type this answer down, तो उस हिसाब से they will consider the marks. They will not see someone who is unprepared for word, but yes, they will see someone who is fully prepared for a word examination, but still it will take some extra time because you are not writing it down with pen and paper, you are writing it down in the word. For the Greek alphabets, again they have mentioned, as I said, beta. So this can also be written as beta underscore I, or it can be written using the subscript text control plus beta I in this manner, right? So both can be done. Then the summations which they have used, they have given two options. Either you can use sigma or sum. Now here what they are specifically talking about is this. This summation sign which you see over here, summation pi I. Now this summation, you can insert the symbol, but it will take a lot of time maybe. So we are not going with the mathematical editor as mentioned. They have said that it is not required for the students to practice in mathematical editor. So what we are preferring how to write this sigma is you can just simply write sigma, and then within the brackets you can mention whatever you want to. Like this entire thing will be covered in the bracket of sigma, right? So this is what they have stated, sigma, or you can use the sum. You can write sum and then you can give your answer. So I'll show you all this in word, so it simplifies the thing. Here we are talking about question number 7, right? So question number 7, and I will show you all how to write the very first equation. So here we'll just simply write beta underscore I, or what you could have done for instead of doing this, I will show you all the alternative as well. Before that, R, and then for I again you can write like this, or you can write it control plus using the subscript, again the control plus my comma R control plus M bracket close. Do not ever forget to remove the subscript portions, otherwise it will not look good. Control plus M, and then again we control plus bracket close. So this is how we have written our very first equation. Suppose if this was a capital M, so I will just capitalize this. Suppose even if you do not want to go through this process, I've showed you all, even if you do not want to use a subscript, you can simply write it this way. You can write R underscore M. So this can also be written, this will be meant as R underscore I. This will be meant as exact same fashion, right? Both of these are equivalent, both of these are correct. Or if you want to write beta properly, what you can do is go to the insert tab. In the symbols section, in the symbol, you will find beta. See, it's already there in my case, but let me just go to the more symbols and show you all. When you type over here Greek, you get the Greek letters. So in the Greek letters over here, which you see, you'll find beta somewhere or the other. See, you have sigma as well, but we are not going to follow this sigma. We are going to follow what IFOA has told us to. So here we have the beta symbol. In the Greek and Coptic, I'll just click on the insert, and when I click on the insert, it comes into my recently used symbols. So the recently used symbols, mostly you see dollar sign, mu, beta, delta, and all those signs which I have recently been using for my all other papers are already there. Then again, two things, underscore I, or what you could have done, or what you could have done is just simply use the subscript and I. So both the things are equivalent. See, what is happening is that when I am typing this I over here, it gets converted to B. To undo this, just click on Control Z and it changes back. Just click on, because that's a default setting of my laptop, as beta I, if I am writing, beta will get converted to B. So in order to undo that, just click on Control Z, which is the shortcut, Control Z for undo, right? Again, Control Plus for moving out of the subscript. This is how you can write your beta I. So I'll just show you all this expression as to how to use sigma. And I will also explain one more thing which is not there in your this paper, but might so happen there that you might face it in some other papers, right? So R, then again Control Plus M. It's a capital M. Control plus capital M, control plus moving out of the subscript equal to, then we have sigma. So over here you can just simply write down sigma, and then what you can do is you can give a colon sign, and then you can within the brackets mention whatever is there within. Just give first bracket if you want to, third bracket, and then whatever is there within. Again, for this I will use pi, and I will use this, or you can use the pi symbol from the insert section, symbol section. You can just go over here and you can use pi from here. Also in the equation tab over here you will see, so I'm not going to use the equation, so let me just delete this. In the insert section, in the symbols section, you will find pie somewhere. And so you can just simply type it down over here. One second, let me just show you all the word. Yeah, so it's pi sigma pi I. Now pi can be written in a number of ways, right? So in today's video, I'll show you all one or two of the ways, and I'll make a common video for all the symbols. But over here in the insert symbol again, when you just go on to the more symbols in the Greek and Coptic itself, where we got our mu and our beta from, just scroll down a bit, and here only itself we will find our pi symbol, right? So here we have the letter pi. And also, if you want to assign your own shortcut key, so you can just click on the shortcut key. You can just change this normal text to any specific you want to, maybe Calibri, and we have pi. You can, in the shortcut key section, you can assign your own shortcut key for the pi symbol. Suppose I want control, just make sure it should be a shortcut key which is not previously used, or it's not a universal shortcut key which we use. It should be something new, right? You can assign your own shortcut key, any shortcut key, control, maybe it can, do not write control P, because control P is already an assigned shortcut for printing. It can be alt P if you want to. So any kind of shortcut which is not used, you can just simply assign it over here as well, right? So we are just, for the time being, clicking on this and clicking on insert, and we get our pi symbol, see? And then we'll just go to our home tab, and there, then we'll type control plus I, control plus again, move out of it. Then we have in this, we have into R, right? So into R multiplied by your capital R, control plus I, control plus, and then just simply close the bracket. So this is how you write your sigma. Now there is one more way to do it. Supposing your sigma runs from I 0 to N. Supposing it runs from I 0 to N. How to do this? You can just simply write sigma in the bracket. I am saying it is running from 0 to N. So 0 comma N. Lower limit 0, upper limit N. Close the bracket. Then give the colon, and then write your entire thing within the brackets. Whatever your sigma follows, right? So this can also be done. Again, this is given by the notations by the IFOA. So I'll just show you all. In the notation section here, you can see the sigma. If it's A to B mu T, you can just simply write sigma A to B colon mu T. This is how they have shown as how you can write sigma. And also you can write, instead of sigma, if you want to write sum A to B, or you can write sum over A to B and then give whatever the expression is within the brackets. So all three are acceptable. I think going with the first or with the second one is more faster and more efficient, right? So we have taken sigma 0 to N, and then whatever you want to write within the brackets. You can also avoid the bracket. According to IFOA, there was no bracket, so you can avoid that. But if you want to make it more, you want to keep it more clear, then you can also use the brackets, right? So I do not see anything new now. In here, I've showed you all how to write pi. Also, I'll show you all the next method of writing pi. I wanted to create a new dedicated video for that, but since we are using it now, I've showed you all one way is going in the insert tab. In the insert tab itself, we have the symbols, and we have symbols, more symbols. You will find pi in the Greek and Coptic. Also, what you can do is the home tab. In the font section, in the font, just type symbol, and you'll get this symbol over here. Once you click on this, and then whatever letter you type, it will get converted to that specific symbol. Suppose I type P. So I've written only P, and it got converted into pi. If I type B, it will get converted into beta. If I write A, it will get converted into alpha. If I write G, it will get converted into gamma. So if you type any letter from your keyboard, see, this is rho. So if you type any word, any symbol from your keyboard now. S is sigma, so V is omega. So this is how you can get all your symbols. What you have to do, just you have to go to the home tab, within the font change the font to a symbol, and then whatever letter you type from your keyboard, whatever letter you type from your keyboard will give you a new kind of a symbol, Greek symbol to that, right? So this is how I have showed you all M for mu. So this is how N for new. So this is how you get your different symbols using the keyboard. It's very efficient, but then yeah, you'll always have to change the symbol section from here. What you can do is you can insert all of it at once and then just simply copy paste it again and again. So I'm just copying and, you know, pasting it over here simply. So that can also be done. I've showed you all two ways. There are many ways to do. What I would suggest, keeping it very simple, do not have to juggle between the symbol, the font. Just go to the insert and go to the symbol section. Keep all the major symbols in your recently used ones, and you can just click on this and get the symbol. Or again, as I showed you all, you can change the font as well, right? So this was about your the seventh question. Here I do not see anything extra. Covariance, again, you can write it down very easily. No extra alphabet which I see. This table again has been created using the tables from the insert section over here, which we did last class. So I'm not going to repeat that again. The eighth question, again, you'll see is exactly a normal typing of words. Sigma, again, I showed you all. You can just simply go to the insert symbol section, and in here you will get your recently used symbols. If you do not have, again, in the more symbols, in the Greek and Coptic itself, you will find your sigma. See, you will find your sigma, and you can just type it down. So you have sigma, no L, nothing new. D2, D1 can be normally written as D1 and D2. Also here I see something new, which is delta B by del B by del sigma. How to write this? We have discussed this yesterday. You can just simply write B divided by D sigma. For sigma, again, I'm just copying, pasting it from here for the time being, right? So this you can simply do, and then once you have written your entire equation, let me just write it down quickly. See, this is what I was talking about. So see, when I'm typing D, I'm getting this delta sign, right? But this is because I'm in the symbols section. This is what I was talking about, that becomes really time taking whenever you again and again change it from the font section. So just simply type it down like this, and we have D. Again, we have the sigma. So I'll just go into my insert editor and I will type it from there, or I can just simply copy paste it from here. So I'll just copy and paste, right? Moving on, minus whatever is there, you can just type it down, and then after this you can write it after giving comma all. So it should be, you can write all, I'm so sorry for that, you can write all partially differentiated. See, this is what we saw in our yesterday's class. Here, when I explained you all the notations given by the IFO itself, they stated that you can write it down whenever you have partial differentiation. You can write stating partial if necessary. So you can just simply state, if you have these kind of partial differentiation, you can say partially differentiating, right? So that can also be done. So that was your eighth question. Coming to the ninth question, also we do not see much of numericals. This numerical can be now easily written. Cij can be written using the subscript, similarly rj. Make sure you give your multiplication symbol or the star sign, rj star sign si star sign x I plus j plus eij. This should be the format of writing. Do not forget to give the star sign in between these. Do not ever forget that, because here you need to make your presentation look as good as possible so that the examiner understands what you are typing, right? So make sure you do that. Yes, if you have time crunch during the exam, you can avoid doing that. So I'll just show you all. C, control plus IJ, control plus equal to R, control plus I. Then again, if I'm avoiding the use of multiplication, what I'll do is control plus space S, it's a small s, so control plus I. Here I had a J, so J, and then space control plus, and then you can write X, control plus I plus J, right? So you can do this. If you want to give multiplication signs, you are welcome, you can do that as well, right? Not an issue at all. So I'll just give a multiplication symbol here. See, this is how you do your exact same thing, or you can avoid here, because since we are using the proper symbols, so proper subscript and superscript, so we can avoid using the star symbols here. When you get a lot of red and blue lines, see, what I was discussing with someone yesterday was that how to remove this red lines and blue lines. We can obviously go to the file section options and we can remove ev. So basically these are the autocorrect features. Wherever you have spelling error, you just right click over here, and these are the spelling mistakes which Excel recognizes to be a spelling mistake, right? This is what Excel recognizes as a spelling mistake. So again, I would not suggest you all or anyone to just switch it off, the autocorrect feature, because in those cases, suppose if you are typing these kind of an answers, and whenever you make any mistake, suppose you make a mistake in spelling of origin, you skip I from here, then also the word will not show you any error. So I would not suggest doing that. Simply ignore these lines, red and blue lines which you get. It's fine that you are getting it, not an issue at all. But do not just simply switch it off, the autocorrect feature, because then what happens that even if you make some spelling mistakes anywhere else, that will also not be recognized. So let me just keep it like this, in this way. Let me just get the red and blue lines, not an issue at all. So what IFOA has talked about in their document is that question 9 can also be written exactly nicely. Again, RJ can be written two ways. You can just simply use the underscore, or you can use a subscript text. We are only left with question number 10 over here. 10 is again a pure theory question. So it's again a theory question. No use of any algebra, just use of some numericals. Again, this numerical can be easily written. Here is the difference I was talking about. If you are using X as your multiplication sign, and also you are using the variable X, then it becomes really confusing. See, here we have the variable X. So even if you're using X here and also X here, this will become really confusing as to what is your variable and where you are using the multiplication sign. So always make it a one thing, one proper standardized thing, that I will always follow multiplication symbol as my this star sign. So I will use star sign as my multiplication always. If you are, suppose in such a kind of a numerical where you do not have any variables, X, Y, Z, A, B, C, do not have any numericals, in those cases, you can definitely go with X as your multiplication. But I would not suggest, only in these cases where, see, you are having, see here, what they have done is they have taken multiplication. Here they have taken it as multiplication, here they have taken it as variable. So these things becomes really confusing for the examiner and for you also when you go back and recheck your answer. So make it one thing, make it a standardized thing, either follow multiplication symbol for your the star sign as your star sign. You can follow X wherever you do not have any variable X, right? So this question is also a pure word question, like you can just simply type it down. All of these which you see 0.99 to the power 9, so this also can be written as simply, we can just write it down as 0.9 to the power 9, or what we can do is 0.9, control shift plus, and see it moves on top, and you can then just type it down 9, 10, whatever it is. So this is it for our September 2019 paper. We'll be solving more and more of papers so that we come across, we solve it, all the notations which is used across the CM2 syllabus. If I skip anything, you can just comment down that, or you can just send me personally. But just wait for a few more videos and we'll be covering all the notations which you'll find in CM2 syllabus. So that was your notification given by the IFOA. That was solving your September 2019 paper. Wait for it, and we'll be solving April 2019 as well. Thank you so much.